We're going to talk about gray, okay? Sharon Greck is here from Benjamin Moore. Lots of gray. How many shades of gray do you have, Sharon Greck?
Well, Benjamin Moore has 166 shades of gray.
Okay, well, that puts 50 to shame.
Absolutely.
166 shades of
gray. Almost as many as Kim has pet peeves.
That's right. You know what? Gray is so hot right now. You go to so many different homes, and gray is the thing.
This is
the reason why. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's a beautiful neutral, and there's something very contemporary about it.
I mean, very contemporary about it. It's very classic, and it's very versatile. And I think that's why we love it. And right now, we're really drawn to nature for design inspiration. We think about design elements like concrete, reclaimed wood, steel. So all of these elements influence the neutral that tends to be the most trendy or the most popular. So the one thing I find with gray, though, is it's very hard to choose. And people have a hard time choosing the right one. And when we say there's 166, that scares them. So I narrowed it down. It is very frightening. So I narrowed it down to 12 of my favorite grays that I've been working with over the past 5 years, just to show how diverse they are. And earlier when people came in, we just had this wall. It's like, those aren't gray. Like, that's pink, that's blue, that's good. And that's really what I wanted to show, because when you're in the paint store and you grab a gray, it's like, I'm gonna go with gray. You grab gray and you think, yeah, that looks gray. And you pick it. But the thing is, you know, I grab a couple of them. They look, you know, looks like a gray.
Yeah, they all kind of look like gray,
look like
but
gray.
Then they're getting a little bit pink, getting a little bit purple.
It really does depend,
right?
It's the undertone that you really want to look for. And gray can be very cool and it can be very warm. So when you put them all together, so I put the ones that I chose from here together, and when you compare them next to each other, that's when you can really see the differences jump out. So they're so obvious. So you might not want to paint your wall like this, although of course you could. You can get a little Benjamin Moore pint sample. But what I would suggest at the very least is getting your chips, cutting them out and laying them out together so that you can see them one next to another, and then you can sort of see the undertones. So as we're saying, gray can be very modern. It can be very traditional. So I've got it sort of in a more contemporary setting here. We've
That's
got
beautiful.
Booth Bay Gray, which is very cool. It's more on the cool side, silver half dollar.
Yeah.
But then you can also get into these really warm red grays, like Silver Fox, which is one of Benjamin Moore's 2015 trend grays, and Portland Gray, which again is almost a pink when you see it here.
That's right. It looks like a really, really pale pink.
Absolutely.
And then this one that looks a bit yellowish.
Absolutely.
Gray Mirage.
It's got a yellow undertone, so it would work very well where you've got beiges and you're transitioning with sort of a green or a yellow based color. But again, it'll still feel gray, that gray mirage in your space. So the important thing about choosing grays in any color is always to remember they're not in isolation. Color is never in isolation. You always have to think about the context that it's in. So in this case, I got this fantastic set from EQ3, very simple, comfy little shades. We're adding some pattern, which I'll talk about in a sec, but I just wanted to show you putting up the grays to this in the store or at your home can really help you. So I'm looking at some of these grays, and you know what? I think Coventry Gray
is a good gray.
So let's paint the wall one solid color. There you go, guys. This is your cue.
So that's what you do.
You make sure
you've got your chips, and obviously you're painting last. Don't make the mistake that so many of us make, including me.
And
don't paint first.
Exactly.
Paint after you have, like, after you have the furniture, you've got your pieces, and you can figure out what's going to work. Is this the color you picked?
Exactly. So this is Coventry Gray.
Nice.
And this ties in with the furniture that we have, so you can kind of see how that all works together. But then the important thing with a monochromatic gray or any monochromatic story is to add texture, to add scale, to add pattern. So that's what we've done here with the beautiful rug. It's got a large scale pattern, because you know our rules, we mix patterns.
Yeah.
We've got the sort of more mid-size scale pattern on the chaise. And then I've created a pattern with the artwork. So that's another way of introducing artwork with the really simple white frames. Now these are for my EQ3, and it doesn't have to do with gray, but I have to tell you, because I was so fascinated, guess what these are, Tracy? Any idea?
I don't know.
Napkins.
You know what? I was gonna guess that, and I thought
napkins.
That sounds so silly.
Isn't that crazy?
Napkins.
They are napkins. And I thought this was so, I'm like, oh, I love that
art.
That
is incredible.
Napkins. So a really interesting DIY project as
well.
That
is such a smart idea.
Absolutely.
Think about how inexpensive that is.
How inexpensive it is. Absolutely.
Very smart.
So when you have gray as your foundation, you can keep it monochromatic, or you can always like pull in a real pop color. You know how much I love orange.
Oh, I love this one.
So look at that.
That's great. The brightness of it.
Oops, let's hide the label. And again, just a little pop of that can kind of, you can pull it out from your artwork, and then you can make gray feel a lot more contemporary.
Absolutely.
So play it up, play with the sheen. I've got an eggshell finish on the wall here. Everything else is matte, so you get a little bit of sheen on the wall and play around with your texture, your pattern, your scale, and you're good to go.
You make it so much easier for us to play because you always come down with goodies for the audience, so you can experiment a little bit. Sharon's brought down gift certificates for 1 gallon of Benjamin Moore paint for everyone in our audience. So get out there and try it out.
And they get that as well.
Your favorite gray.
That is great. That's going to help you out.
Yes.
Excellent.
Give you some inspiration.
Very nice.